In 2013 YouGov poll, 41% of 18 to 24-year-olds believed that religion is the number one cause of evil in the world. Only 25% said they believed in God, 19% in a higher power, and 38% said they believed in no God or spirit at all. 82% felt influenced by their parents, 77% by friends, 21% by celebrities, and a low 12% that they were influenced by religious leaders. These statistics show a clear lack of faith in British youth. My name is James Taylor, I'm an atheist with a group of students, and we're going to explore the fact whether the British youth is losing to religion or not. So through your documentary about teenagers, it only felt right to find some failed teenagers to find out their views on religion. That's why I met with 18-year-old Jennifer Roberts to find out why her religious upbringing conflicts with her sexuality. Meeting in a local coffee shop for a quick chat and hopefully we'll gain some insight into what makes her feel this way.
Hiya, Jen.
Hi.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine, thanks.
Do you want a cup of tea?
Yes, please.
Lovely. So, Jennifer, can I call you Jen?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, well, Jen, obviously today, as you know, we're talking about statistics, the fact that, you know, British youth and, you know, young people losing religion, you know, what do you feel about that?
Well, I think the majority of people I know either don't believe, just straight out don't believe in God, or don't go to church and don't really, like, go, like, pray or anything.
Yeah.
So I think it's a generational thing more than anything. Like, I know a lot of older people, like my parents still go to church and stuff, but you don't get too many people like our age that do.
Right. Now, you yourself are an atheist. It hasn't always been that way, has it?
No. I was raised Catholic, which was fun. I got like the whole like baptism, Holy Communion, everything, all that. And I sort of got to about 13, 14 and thought, I just wasn't really as into it.
Yeah.
And as I was sort of like coming to terms with my sexuality, it was kind of like the stuff that was talked about in the church and what I felt in my own life didn't really match up, and it sort of didn't, it didn't really like work with me, so I just thought it's not really any point in me worshipping this God that doesn't love me. Okay. Or like,
makes sense. So, you know, what's changed, like, because you now declare yourself as an atheist, so what made you, like, you know, lose it, religion, you know?
Probably, like, the main thing was, like, my sexuality.
And yeah.
I just didn't really feel like I connected with the church. I didn't really, like, identify with the, like, beliefs of what the church wanted. And then, like, we were studying like RE in school and we were learning things and it didn't really all match up, like the things that my teachers were telling me and then like what was actually happening in the Bible. It was like, well, if he did love us, then he wouldn't let us suffer.
So does being, you know, for you, being a lesbian, does that conflict with the religion? Does it conflict with...
I had a really tough time when I realised that I wouldn't be able to get married in church.
Right.
That was a really big like one for
me. Emotional.
Yeah. But I think like it kind of came with like emotional maturity. Like, I can get married in the field or anything; it doesn't really matter.
Yeah.
But I mean, like, I know like I have a really good friend whose parents are very, very. I think they're like Baptist, like something like down there. And he is literally like, I can never tell my parents that he's gay. I can never tell them because I will not be allowed back in the house.
And like, I think all your friends felt the same way at school, you know, in RE and stuff like that. That's actually quite upsetting. I mean, that for you, religion is what's holding you back.
Yeah. Well, I think for some people it will hold them back, but I do know a lot of people that do really enjoy their religion and like they really enjoy like the community aspect of it, because, you know, these people all tend to like live in the same area, they go to the same church, the children go to the same school, they went to the same school, so. But I think when you've kind of found like your collection of people anyway. Yeah. For me, it was my friends, you know. For the people, it can be other people in the parish or wherever their religion will take them.
So why do you think it's a religion nowadays?
Well, I just think the church is a bit out of touch with what we actually go through. And I just don't feel like what they talk about, like, in the Bible, I just don't think it really, like, connects to us in our lives now. And I just think if they modernised it a bit more, then maybe more people would stay in the church or come to the church, but as it is right now, I just don't think that's going to happen. If all churches like the churches I've been to, then I can't see any young people being really interested in it.
So the event went really well with Jenny yesterday. We found out a lot of information about what she thinks about religion and teens. She said that most of her friends are on the same page as her and agree that nowadays teens aren't really that with the religion. So I decided to take her to a church, not a traditional one, but a modernised one, like she said herself. You know, she said that the church should be more modernised this day and it should be different than how it used to be. So that's why I'm taking her to the Lighthouse Church in Eccles for a service for young people. We're here at Lighthouse Church waiting for the service. It's going to be really exciting. Jen, what do you think?
Yeah, I'm just really excited for it to start. It should be fun.
Yeah.
So I'm here with Kinetic Ivy, and guys, do you just want to talk about what it is that you do exactly?
So Kinetic Ivy is a band that does music for people who don't know the gospel.
Yeah.
Regardless of your age, we find that the issue with music these days, or the church these days, is that they don't use language that young people understand. And so as Kinetic Ivy, you know, our purpose is to use words that young people can understand. You know, we believe that God is not complex. He's a simple God and he's basic, and so we, you know, we want to be able to relay God to people who don't understand who he is, and so that's why we write the music that we write, and we've seen amazing responses from it. People have been able to understand what it is that we're saying, so
I mean, I noticed that it's not just your songwriting, it's the way you perform it as well. You make it so, like, entertaining in a way that people might not expect from a church. Mm-hmm. Do you think that's important, you know?
Yeah.
I saw backflips, I saw lights going, it was great.
Yeah, it's like what Meryl said, it's really important just to be relevant.
Yeah.
Like, nowadays, like, kids are thinking a church is boring, yeah. Younger kids especially. And we're just trying to, as young people, to bring the gospel in such a way that it's not boring at all. Like, we can have fun. There's not a saying as in, like, if you a Christian, you are going to have a boring life.
Yeah.
It's more like showing them, like, look here, we have fun as well. We love what we're doing, and we're just trying to show them, like, look here, stop looking at a church as a boring thing. Mm-hmm. Look at it as in, like, young people, try to make it fun, just be, and that's what we're doing. We're just being relevant, basically.
Yeah.
And yeah, like, to add on to what Gilles said, we found that music is a foundation that we use,
yeah,
actually in like to bring the gospel across. So if you look at 90% of youth people, they love music.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
already when we do music, that's already got them.
Yeah,
they're interested in that. And
yeah,
we actually go into schools, we go into places, we perform, we do our music, obviously. And immediately they're open to hearing what we say and what we have to share. So
that's
just a platform for us to actually introduce what we believe
and
just share the word of God with them.
Yeah.
So everything you did was, like, so engaging. Have you got, is that a response that you've received all over, you know? So have people, like, contacted you, maybe saying that your music has helped them understand their faith more?
Definitely. There's a lot of responses on that. Because what we do with music, we don't just write gospel music. So we write music that's going to connect with them. We're trying to bring that message across in a very relevant way, so that that young people get it. They don't just shut it down, because that's what's happening with a lot of gospel music these days. people don't want to listen to it because it talks about God. And
thank you.
So I'm here with Chanel and Naomi, who comes to the Excel service. Is it? Do you come every month, is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what is it that you find so, you know, appealing about the services that you come to?
Well, like, obviously I love church and I love coming to church, but just seeing, like, young people step out and just take to the platform and just be bold and, like, so passionate for God really inspires me. And I feel like I'm definitely on a rocky journey at the moment, but it just inspires me every Sunday to come and see, like, there is a place for young people in church and there is a place and a platform for us to step out and actually show what God has given us and be able to worship Him in our way as well.
Yeah, so it's made it more, like, accessible, I suppose, to young people. It's not just sitting down in the church singing hymns, it's actually getting involved.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
We have different people, which is good. It's like, it's fun because it keeps it, like, it's not the same.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it keeps it, like, fresh and interesting,
yeah, yeah.
Like, you want to come back.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Like, if it was just the same person, it'd be a bit like, okay, we know their songs now.
Yeah.
What else is there out there?
Yeah.
So, yeah.
So, like, how do you find it, like, easy to follow your faith, keep your faith in, like, a society, I suppose, where, you know, it's not religious out there,
yeah,
for young people especially. So how do you maintain your faith?
It's incredibly hard, yeah.
Yeah.
Like, there's so many pressures, but I feel like on a journey you become stronger and you become stronger to be able to not withstand them, but be able to be like, this is my God and I'm going to live for Him, if
yeah,
you know what I mean.
So religion for you has been, like, a way to, like, cope with things, a way, like, a way to learn about yourself, I suppose.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So is there any, you know, particular mass or preacher that has really spoken to you? Is there any messages that you've taken, I suppose?
I don't want to sound like I suck up, but obviously Pastor Paul, because he's been through everything that, like, most of the young people I know have been through, but more.
Yeah.
And it's like, you think all the things that someone's been through and they've got to the place that they are now.
Yeah.
And the things that he speaks to are really relevant. Like, he could speak about something that's written in the Bible thousands, thousands, thousands of years ago, but still make it current to this day.
Yeah.
And I think that's something that's really interesting.
So I'm here with Paul, who is a pastor at a Lighthouse Church. And so what do you do for the church that makes the word of the Bible so relevant to young people?
I think it's really important that you preach out of your own relationship with God. I think that authenticates a lot of what you say, so it makes it real. Not because you're trying to make it real, because it's real for you. I think within the Lighthouse we have kind of repackaged and reinvented the way church does things, made it, not changed the message, but changed the methodology of how we do church. So it's relevant, it's meaningful in people's lives. Certainly I believe, as the lead pastor, I certainly believe that, you know, this generation have got, wow, they're so gifted, they're so talented. It's fantastic to see the new generations coming through with their passion and their gifting and their abilities.
So how did you even go to Lighthouse Church in Lewis?
I got some interesting points out of everyone, especially Kinetic IV, who seem like a really good band of role models for the young people. And Chanel and Naomi raised some good points about how their faith has helped them through adolescence, and people like Pastor Paul seem to be giving them good advice and helping them on that journey. And the church as a whole just seemed like a really good community for everyone there, not just young people, but for everyone. There wasn't just young people at the service, it seemed to be everyone. That's me in the corner.